sacrifice. It's speaking to you tonight. You'll hear a second voice.
Bright one of the heavens, wise Ishtar, mistress of the gods whose yes is truly yes, proud one among the gods whose command is supreme, mistress of heaven and earth, who rules in all places. Ishtar, at your name all heads are bowed down. I, Karos, son of my parents, have bowed down before you. May my body be purified like lapis lazuli, may my face be bright like alabaster. Like shining silver and reddish gold, may I not be dull. Anu, Shab, Om, Gig, Abzu, Kish, Agiga, Gar, Shag, Da, Sisi, A, Marada, Ya, Dingir, Ud, Kalama, Saniku, Dingir, Ninab, Guyu na hara niku gayashu shangmuku tu. Anu shab am gig abzu kish agiga gar shang da sisi amarada ya dingir ud kalama saniku dingir ninam guyu na hara niku gayashu shangmuku tu. Anu, Shab, Am, Gig, Abzu, Kish, Agiga, Gar, Sham, Da, Sisi, Amarada, Ya, Dingir, Ud, Kalama, Saniku, Dingir, Ninab, Gu, Ya, Na, Raniku, Galayashu, Shamuku, Tu. Anu, Shab, Am, Gig, Abzu, Kish, Agiga, Gar, Sham, Da Sisi Amarada Ya Dingir Ud Kalama Siniku Dingir Ninab Gu Yu Na Araniku Ga Yashu Shangmuku Tu. Okay. Welcome to the Wednesday episode. This is the finale, and today we'll be going over Mercury, the 8x8. Its color is purple. Communication, intellect, writing, contracts, information, wisdom, science, and memory. Okay. Oh, I almost forgot the most important thing. Can't do this without honey. Bread of the cult of the dead, in its place I eat, in the court it prepared. Water of the cult of the dead, in its place I drink. A queen am I, who has become estranged to the cities. She that comes from the lowlands in a sunken boat am I. I am the virgin goddess, hostile to my city, a stranger in my streets. Muse ga mana uru nabor meyan su amagimean. O spirit, who understand thee, who comprehend thee. I come with gifts of offering. I give you water. I give you bread with honey. Please accept these offerings for coming to me tonight. Your wisdom is ever so valuable. My goddess Ereshkigal, reveal unto me what I must know. I'm seeing smoke from the incense rise. But not from behind it, but in front of it. As you can clearly see, I have it behind me, but I'm seeing it in the mirror. The mirror is facing at an angle towards the ceiling. seeing the mirror vibrate and pulsate. Like it's a living thing. See me and me standing in a room. It's pitch black. There's a door open, letting in the light. We're standing at each other. This me is different. This me is the one I show to the world. This me is tired. Exhausted. He says he's tired of the illusion. Telling me to reflect. To be true to myself. Not just with other people, but with myself. Open grassy field. The wind is blowing hard, but it's a cool breeze. Lightning hits the ground. It's Marduk. It's Marduk. He emerges from the lightning. He's holding out his hand. He tells me that he's proud of me. For coming back and studying. He'd be even more happier to continue, and that in my time I will ascend the gates. I will walk with him as they walk with me now. They are here with me now. But in due time, and I shouldn't have to feel excluded or inferior. Those who walk the gates in their time. Shouldn't rush it. The only competition is the one in my mind. And if I need help, just call upon them, and they will come, regardless of the fact. He says that Ereshkigal is not the only one who is looking out for me. That him and Nergal and Ishtar and Nabo and the rest of them are watching out for me. That all I have to do ask, and they will guide me. It says Anu watches me and waits the day for me to join him. For he has so many things to teach me. Marduk says, don't get caught up in the mundane. This is all just a distraction. He said it's just a distraction to keep me from obtaining what I've sought so long. Not just knowledge, but a clear mind, a clear body, balanced. He shows me his axe, the one he used to cut Tiamat in half. He tells me that just because this slayed Tiamat doesn't mean that it's any more valuable. I'm not understanding that part. Not any more valuable to any other person. It doesn't take a god to wield such a weapon. A simple man can wield it, as long as he has the proper training, the determination and will. Strength is mundane. It's nothing to the one who has knowledge. The determination and will. And that I must wield my axe and slay my Tiamat. Things that hold me back. The things that stop me from being happy. He points to the air, saying, where are the things that control me? He points to the sides of me, saying, where are the chains that bind me? I stand here now with him as an equal. Free. So why can I not do this any other time? Pats me on the shoulder, saying that he is proud of me. He says to continue my progress, and that he'll rejoice when he sees me, when I enter his gate. He's heading back to the thunder and lightning. He turns around and points to me. He says that the key to everything is to keep following it doesn't make sense. The key to following what? To be free. The key to be free is with Kingu. He leaves, reminding me that he's there, as all the other gods, the Dingir, if you will, that they're always there with me. And all I gotta do is just call upon them for help. And he's gone. He's gone. Yeah, that concludes this episode of the Ereshkigal Chronicles. Anu, Shub, Am, Gig, Abzu, Kish, Agiga, Gar, Shong, Da, Sisi, Amurada, Ya, Dingir, Ud, Kalama, Saniku, Dingir, Ninab, Guyu, Na, Araniku, Gaya, Shu, Shong, Muku, Tu. Anu, Shub, Am, Gig, Abzu, Kish, Agiga, Gar, Shong, Da, Sisi, Amurada, Ya, Dingir, Ud, Kalama, Seniku, Dingir, Ninab, Guyu Naraniku Gayashu Shamuku Tu. Anu Shab Am Gig Abzu Kish Giga Gar Sham Da Sisiyama Rada Ya Dingir Ud Kalama Saniku Dingir Ninab Uyu Naraniku Gayashu Shamuku Tu. Anu Shab Am Gig Abzu Kish Agiga Gar Shang Da Sisi Amarada Ya Dingir Ud Kalama Saniku Dingir Ninab Guyu Nara Niku Gayashu Shangwuku Tu. Right one of the heavens, wise Ishtar. Mistress of the gods whose yes is truly yes. Proud one among the gods whose command is supreme. Mistress of heaven and earth who rules in all places. Ishtar, at your name all heads are bowed down. I, Karos, son of my parents, have bowed down before you. May my body be purified like lapis lazuli. May my face be bright like alabaster. Like shiny silver and reddish gold. May I not be dull. And I thank you, Ereshkigal, for showing me what I must know. May your journey back be a pleasant one.